Clouds. Lesson 1. What are clouds? Clouds are such a beautiful addition to the wide open blue sky. It's so much fun to see how different the clouds are from one day to the next. And it's exciting to find clouds that look like things that are familiar to us, such as an animal or a person. So, what exactly is a cloud? A cloud is a large collection of very tiny droplets of water or ice crystals. The droplets are so small and light that they can float in the air. All air contains water, but near the ground it's usually in the form of an invisible gas called water vapor. When warm air rises, it expands and cools. Cool air can't hold as much water vapor as warm air. So some of the vapor condenses onto tiny pieces of dust that are floating in the air and forms a tiny droplet around each dust particle. When billions of these droplets come together, they become a visible cloud. A cloud forms when it's heated by the sun. As it rises, it slowly cools, reaches its saturation point, and then the water condenses, forming a cloud. As long as the cloud and the air that it's made of is warmer than the outside air around it, it floats. Clouds are white because they reflect the light of the sun. Light is made up of colors of the rainbow. When you add all these colors together, you get white. The sun appears to be yellow because it sends out more yellow light than any other color. Clouds reflect all the colors the exact same amount, so they look white. So, why do some clouds, especially storm clouds, look gray? If the cloud gets thick enough or high enough, all the light above does not make it through, causing a gray or dark look. Also, if there are a lot of clouds around, their shadow adds to the gray appearance. Clouds move with the wind. Sometimes clouds, such as the cirrus clouds, travel at more than 100 miles per hour. Clouds that are a part of a thunderstorm usually travel at about 30 to 40 miles per hour. Clouds form at different heights of the atmosphere, depending on the amount of water vapor a cloud contains, or the temperature at the height it's at, the wind, or the interplay of other air masses. Now we've learned a bit about clouds. In the next lessons, you will learn about different types of clouds, so that when you look up at the clouds, you can be familiar with and name the cloud you're looking at. There are many more things to learn about clouds. An activity to go along with this lesson is to go to the library and check out one or more books about clouds and see what other things you can learn about them.